My name's Josh, and this is my construction nightmare. I'm a firefighter. I've been in the fire service for 12 years. Currently, I'm a training officer. So I travel around the state and I teach firefighters skills that they need to be safe. And I have two kids, Annie and Wyatt. After divorce, I wanted to make sure my kids had a home with dad. Things really started off bad from the beginning. The very first day, the fire department came because we had a natural gas line because appropriate locates were not called. After that, the county came and put a stop work order on the demolition because we didn't have a demolition permit. Nearing the end of the excavation stage, we got another stop work order because SIA had not secured the building permit to build on the property. I think we waited 2 months. And the weather, it just sort of took a beating in the middle of wintertime. I'm pushing my $400,000 limit already. We're right about the 50% level of completion. I can improvise for 6 months, but it's been over a year and a half, pushing 2 years now of that improvising. I was supposed to have secured an acceptable place to live for my kids.
My name is Sia. I'm the owner of Precision Custom Builders. Josh hired me to basically be in charge of building him his dream home.
So Josh is inside, but I wanted to talk to you first, contractor.
Yeah, absolutely. The beginning of the project was awesome. Walking through exactly what Josh wants as a contractor, as a builder, being that person that could bring it into life for him. It was definitely exciting for me.
Josh is saying that there's a couple issues and problems. Would you agree?
Not necessarily. You know, I've built numerous houses in the city. I've built two apartment complexes. You know, when it comes to houses, for me, I feel like it's butter.
This is not butter.
Don't look at this house right now with the house wrap flying off. You know, we get 80 mile an hour winds over here. We tried to waterproof the house. Ultimately speaking, have we had obstacles? Have we had issues? Sure, 100%. Material shortages, labor shortages.
Do you think it was just like bidding too low?
Not necessarily. I'm a commercial builder by trade. I budgeted based on the numbers that I'm used to in the city. Things are different up here. Everything that we have done up to this point has cost up to double of what it should cost in the city. I haven't made a dime on this project.
How much has he given you guys so far?
$345,000.
So out of the $345,000, do you have any of that left in reserve to keep moving, or has that been spent all the way? Or?
I have spent that $345,000. And I know we have a little bit of money left on the draws with the bank, but we're not gonna be able to get that until we meet the milestones that we have to meet.
Without milestones, how are you supposed to know how far the project should be? When you do a loan, the mortgage company will say like, hey, we're not issuing out another check until you hit these milestones. $30,000 gets us this far, $50,000 gets us this far, $100,000 gets us this far, and then you move forward. So what is the next milestone?
We have to insulate and get drywall finished.
How much money do you think it'll take to get to that point?
I would put the number at around $40,000.
Gotcha, so that's the next thing, is hitting the next milestone, getting the next draw, and having you finish the project.
Absolutely, I'm here, right? I'm gonna finish your house, you know what I mean?
Awesome. Today, I'm meeting with Sia and Evergreen. Once we do the drywall, the insulation, and the siding, we get all that done, then we could get the next milestone and the next payment from the bank. Well, this is awesome because I'm seeing movement. I think every homeowner likes to see movement. I like to see movement. Guys on stilts, look at this. Beautiful, love seeing that. Love seeing guys upstairs. This is great. While the insulation is being installed inside, we really gotta make sure that the house is rewrapped to protect it from the wind and weather.
Feels great to see some progress and move forward. Just getting closer to that finish line.
All right, it's a wrap. Gosh, this is a horrible dad joke.
We are bringing in all of his furnishings and accessories. I feel like Josh's vibe is really laid back. He really likes, I think, the warm tones and things, but he doesn't want it to be dark. So I feel like what he wants really reflects his personality. So that's why we picked the taupes and the browns and the greens and the golds. I just wanted nature to be inside as well as outside for him.
I think it's pretty straight, but...
This is the post.
Honestly, love Poonam. She is a master at her craft, but if it wasn't for Everett, I don't know what I would do.
I'm looking very forward to this 30-page booklet. Only 15 more rooms to go?
Yeah, and 20 lamps.
20 lamps?
20 lamps.
Oh, there it ain't so. How about that?
You remember how it was before?
Well, I remember it from the beginning.
The wrapping was falling off. I mean, there was just like trash everywhere, just materials everywhere.
We've came a long way, Rico.
A long way.
I lost track on how long it's been, but this is so nice. I got stairs?
You got stairs. Now we don't have to jump 4 feet to get up there.
Man, we built that ground up quite a bit, huh?
Yeah. We got the driveway, which is now a functioning driveway.
I'm thrilled already. Look at that deck.
We have the glass paneling on the deck right there. We have the pillars made out of stone.
Well, I can't wait to look inside.
You excited?
Yeah.
Let's check it out.
Let's do it. It ain't so. How about that? Holy moly. Guys. This is a lot to take on, Rico. This is a lot to look at one time.
You're not wrong.
I'm looking across the room. I got my fire going over there.
You're an evergreen. It's beautiful on the outside. We try to bring that in on the inside. So we went with this dark green color. If it wasn't for Poonam, C, and I working together, it would not have happened like this.
I remember going through everything with her, and I just said, do what you do. I am not disappointed. Yeah.
Okay.
The main room.
The main room.
Appreciate the rug.
It gets cold out here.
I'm not always one to take my boots off all the time, but this is
I know
it's durable, and this is probably a good call for the house, I would say. On to the main bathroom. Look at this vanity.
Oh yeah.
Wow. The brass look.
Yeah.
Look at those mirrors.
This is the reason you got this house right here. Come on.
It's the view, all about the view.
I'm jealous.
Well, you're invited anytime.
Yeah, no, I'm jealous.
This makes the deck, man.
And before, this was kind of a death trap. Not fun.
Yeah.
But we got this custom railing in, and it worked out beautifully.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not going to lie. It was very close for the basement not being finished.
I knew things were getting pretty tight.
With Sia helping out and myself helping out, we got the basement finished.
Oh, man. Look at this. All these pictures.
Yeah. Downstairs, obviously budget was a thing. I wanted to do LVP floors down here, but honestly, I think carpet is a better route to take.
Oh yeah. I'll be honest, I like the carpet better. Annie's room.
Yep.
I can't wait for her to see this.
We actually got the nameplates custom made as well. Poonam definitely used the same greens, whites throughout the house.
This is Annie. This is Annie. The horses, she loves horses.
Let's check out Wyatt's room.
God, this is cool. Wyatt's room, we got the same cutout.
Yeah.
I cannot wait for these kids to see their rooms.
It's been 2 years, they haven't had a place to stay. Where they could claim their own room, and now we have it.
They have it now.